As always, let's start by checking out the progress of Tesla Gigafactory construction in Austin, Berlin, and Shanghai. Then we also have some pretty amazing news regarding Tesla's upcoming battery day. And of course, we have to talk about the Tesla stock split.
Then Nikola adds another CGI render to its vaporware CGI product portfolio. Hyundai refuses to work with Nikola while launching Ioniq as a pure EV brand. VW wants to also produce battery packs in the US. CATL says they will soon have tech to boost EV ranges to 800 kilometers. And Lucid wants to also build SUVs and pickup trucks.
And also some cool news regarding autonomous delivery bots and air taxis. Namely, Japan wants to have them ready in Tokyo by 2023. And air taxi trials in New York State. Really a lot to talk about, so stay tuned.
Tesla now has 3 gigafactories under construction on 3 different continents. How freaking awesome is that? At Giga Berlin, we have already walls going up at the drive unit building, and even the roof tiles are now being attached to the roof lattice structure. Progress at the paint shop is equally as fast, with it now being completely surrounded by massive concrete walls, the roof here now also being finished in large parts. Let's as always compare this to Giga Shanghai's progress, and we can see that we are now already where Giga Shanghai was in May 2019. This means that construction at Giga Berlin is actually even faster than construction was at Giga Shanghai. We have to correct our prediction for the first Model Y trial units rolling off the assembly line from April forward to already March 2021. Talking of Giga Shanghai itself, work on the outside is all but finished now, while the assembly lines for Model Y construction are being already installed. Demand for Tesla in China is going through the roof, by the way, and estimates are rolling in that Tesla will sell about 100,000 cars in China this year. Next year, with Model Y, we'll probably see that number rise to 200,000 for China. Remember that only 2 years ago, this was about how many cars Tesla was selling worldwide. That's what we call exponential growth. Poor legacy car makers.
At Giga Austin, the flattening of the whole area is still going on at breakneck speed. Soon, all the surrounding ponds will be filled. We can again see the geotextile membrane here. Trees will also be gone soon, so that we have one big flat area. And we assume that already in about 1 or 2 weeks, cables and underground lines will be installed.
While on the topic of Tesla, there are some pretty epic news regarding Battery Day. We now have a specific time, namely September 22nd at 2:30 p.m. Pacific time, when the event will take place, by the way, together with the shareholder meeting. Battery Day and shareholder meeting will be packed into one single event. It will take place at the Fremont factory, and we know why. Because they will reveal a new production line for their in-house built 1 million mile 300 watt hours per kilogram batteries. They will most likely also present a roadmap to 350 watt hours per kilogram battery energy densities, or surprise us by actually already jumping to such energy densities with their newest in-house built batteries, who knows. But Elon gave a cryptic comment on Twitter, which is actually not so cryptic. He said, "One day soon, I will wear this outfit," which is, as we can see, a plaid outfit, which in turn means that we most likely will see the plaid Model S and possibly even the plaid Model X being revealed at Battery Day. These new high-end models will not only have even crazier acceleration with a tri-motor setup, but we assume that the range will most likely also be boosted to about 500 miles real-world range, and we strongly think that Elon will surprise us with a refreshed interior and exterior design for Model S, but maybe also for Model X. It would make a lot of sense to introduce a new design top-down. It would be an excellent strategy in order not to cannibalize current Model S and X sales. If you want the new design, you will have to go for the most insane and expensive versions. So yes, it's only one more month to go now, and we are very sure this event will blow our minds.
and please consider to subscribe to our channel. Because first, it's completely free. And then, every week, you will get the latest updates on Tesla, SpaceX, and also other disruptive technologies from us. Your support will really help this channel to grow. So now, still on the topic of Tesla, they are planning a 5-for-1 stock split at a current valuation of over $1,600 per share. The stock isn't exactly cheap anymore. Thus, a stock split would result in a share price of suddenly only $320, which is certainly much more attractive to many people. Funny that not long ago, the Tesla stock was actually trading in this price regime before the split. So the Tesla stock split will in essence mean that more people can afford to buy some shares, which will of course have a very positive impact on the price. But this is, by the way, only our opinion. We are not professional financial advisors, so please always do your own research before investing. And now, regarding our favorite CGI vaporware company, Nikola received an order for 2,500 battery electric garbage waste trucks from Republic Services. So this is another CGI product they can add to their ever-increasing CGI portfolio. By the way, because Nikola doesn't have even one real product yet, not even a factory, as you all already know, Hyundai refused to work with Nikola. Yes, really. Nikola offered Hyundai to work together with them on fuel cell vehicles, but Hyundai politely declined. Could it have something to do with the fact that Nikola cannot contribute anything of value to Hyundai because they just cannot produce anything real? We find that a bit harsh of Hyundai, because Nikola could at least contribute to make some nice CGI renderings of future Hyundai products. That would already be quite something. Still on the topic of Hyundai, it seems that they have given up on the hydrogen fuel cell. Again, we wonder why. Could it have something to do with the fact that Tesla is just completely taking over the electric car market in their home country of South Korea, thus forcing them to abandon the inefficient fuel cell and start producing EVs in earnest? Yeah, it probably has something to do with that. Therefore, Hyundai now launched Ioniq as a separate full EV brand. And not only will Ioniq produce electric cars, but they also want to make them design-wise futuristic. We wonder why suddenly all car makers try out more aggressive and futuristic designs. Maybe the insane success of Tesla's Cybertruck could have something to do with that. By the way, the Tesla Cybertruck now has over 700,000 reservations. That's right, over 700,000 reservations.
Which shows the legacy car makers that people actually do want some new and refreshing designs, and not the same old boring designs we've been forced to buy now for decades. Thanks Tesla for forcing all car makers to go fully electric and to build new and cool looking EVs. VW meanwhile has revealed plans to build not only electric cars in their Chattanooga factory, but also to develop cells and complete battery packs there. So they are learning from Tesla to build everything in-house. Smart move, VW, smart move. Only companies that will switch to EV and battery cell production ASAP can survive this disruptive era. CATL also seems to understand the importance of EVs, and they announced a new tech where they want to include the batteries into the chassis of the car itself in order to boost range into the 800 km or 500 mile range. Excellent. The more 500 mile EVs we have, the better, since this will accelerate the death of the internal combustion engine car even more.
Last week, we talked about the Lucid Air, where the estimated EPA range for the top model with a 130 kWh battery pack stands at an astounding 517 miles. Now Lucid announced that they are also planning to build an SUV and a pickup truck. Excellent. Hopefully they will have the same ultra-efficient aerodynamics and cool design.
Regarding autonomous delivery bots, thousands of people living in Houston rely on the Nuro autonomous delivery bot to get their deliveries, which is of course perfect in this time of pandemic. Now, to all viewers in the Houston area, we are very curious. Have you ever used the Nuro delivery bot? If yes, could you share your experiences with us? We would be very glad to share them on this channel.
Now, regarding air taxis, a lot is going on as always. First, Japan is suddenly going full eVTOL, which, by the way, stands for Electric Vertical Takeoff and Landing. The Japan-based company SkyDrive has been working on the two-seater eVTOL here. And now the Japanese government announced to support the company with the goal to make this flying air taxi commercially available by 2023. Meanwhile, in Rome, trials with eVTOLs are starting as part of a $900,000 research program. No, not this Rome. This one here in New York. Yes, there's a Rome in New York. Seriously. But is there also a New York in Rome? Anyways, this trial is part of a NASA program on eVTOLs, and Oneida County will develop automation technology to support high-density vertiport operations for the eVTOLs. This will certainly be another piece of the puzzle to bring eVTOLs to the mainstream market.
And if you missed the last week's disruption report, you can watch this video here.
So thanks a lot for watching the show, and I would say, on to the future! That's why this Square is so successful, because with their cash app, this app I taught you, you can just buy like 1/5 of the stock. It doesn't matter. Fine?
Yes.
So thanks a lot.